myself OG. Yeah, my end games never go OT. And if so, time's up like OC. And if not, then wasn't my calling. Catch me like falling, catch me like spalling. Rest in peace to my Cali Gold Rush is here, we never stalling. If all goes down and still get fouled, understand, man, that's how we're supposed to be. Catch me, I'm ballin', catch me, I'm ballin'. Catch me like Spalding, catch me like Spalding. PMD, DMC, vitamin like GNC. Lupe, catch me, I'm ballin', catch me, I'm ballin'. Catch me like Spalding, catch me like Spalding. ABB to ALC, man, we stay on a J-O-B, yeah. We make our name known, baby, it's going down worldwide, we right here.
Hello and welcome back to the Dietz and Stevens All Out Sports Show. And let's go to some MLB as we're going to the Oakland Athletics. Brandon McCarthy is progressing.
Brandon McCarthy's hair is growing back faster. So, and that big scar on the right side of his head is hardly noticeable anymore. So that's very, very, very big for the A's and having him possibly in the playoffs. The Oakland Athletic pitcher feels nearly normal again just more than 3 weeks after undergoing a brain surgery following a frightening injury in which a line drive off the bat of the Angels shortstop Eric Ibar struck him September 5th. So good. In fact, doctors have cleared him to play like catch Saturday. A big deal in his recovery and for his immense boredom. So he's also obviously bored with this, but it's just regular medical procedures, and I'm glad that he's starting to recuperate a little bit faster, and hopefully he can be back for the playoffs and to help a team that I think the A's need more pitching. And if Brandon McCarthy is able to come back during the postseason, that'll be humongous, especially if Brandon McCarthy comes back for the wild card game. That probably won't happen, but he'll be big, especially to come back because of Brett Anderson's injury. He's out for the rest of the regular season. So, Robert, do you think this is good for the A's? Do you think it's a good idea for the A's to have McCarthy going fast to get the wild card start, or do you think he should slow down and then he can possibly get the ALDS spot if they win the wild card game?
I think he should try to get one spot before the ALDS game because you look at a situation where he's really crucial, and you don't want to, pitch him in a situation where he could, not get used to pitching, because I know he's been out for weeks. But interesting, in fact, that I think he should pitch one more game. This is what McCarthy actually had to say. I have fast-growing hair. I'm already at the point now that I don't know what to do with it. Do I shave it again and keep showing off the scar? I'm going to have to make decisions soon. I've never shaved my head before. Now with the scar, I can walk around San Francisco and look tough.
That's a great way to put it. That's putting some comedy into a terrible situation, a terrible problem. But he's putting some comedy in there. He's having fun. Well, not really, but he's 8-6 this year with 3.24 ERA in his sixth big league season and second with the A's. He was 9-9 last year with a 3.32 ERA. He was on the cover of ESPN, the magazine, with his very, very attractive wife. She's a model, and they've known each other since high school, so nice hookup, Brandon McCarthy. The pitcher expects his off-season throwing program to be like any other this winter while monitoring himself for concussion symptoms, so that does not sound good if he wants to come back to the postseason. McCarthy stepped back onto the field Friday for the first time to accept the nomination for the Roberto Clemente Award, accompanied by his wife, Amanda. And that's what I'm talking about. His wife is very attractive. I'm sorry.
Yes, Steven, I'll have to agree with you on that.
Have you seen that ESPN, the magazine?
Yes.
Yes? Let's give a round of applause. A round of applause. There. Yeah, we got Nicole back there. She's clapping too. Say hi, Nicole.
Hey!
Yep. Yeah. Cha. Okay. Let's keep going, Robert. So this is A's. I think they're in second place in the wild card or first
place?
Yes,
they are.
Okay, they're in second place because the Orioles, they are just like a game back of the Yankees and
three games back from the Texas Rangers.
Yep, that's. Do you think that is a better choice to go for the division or for the wild card spot?
Well, they already have a wild card spot. They could go for the division. I think they have a chance.
That'd be a good idea, though, to go for the division because they'll get a higher spot and they'll have a bye on that wild card game. That'd be big.
I know Texas. You know, the Texas has been kind of a sleeper team. No one's really been talking about them. How that race is kind of maybe pushing it a little bit. They're pushing and pushing. And so when you look at both teams, as maybe this will be good, but this is what McCarthy had to set up what's next. Normal, I'm just starting to go in athropo here and boredom, so I've got to do something physically to get blood going again, and then when it gets into the off season, a lot of it's just based on concussion systems. If I get headaches or something, I'm a little dizzy, something then just scale back. I think you just push against the wall until you find out what your body's going to do and what it can go through, and then just sort of resume as normal.
So that's good and bad at the same time, bud. Let's go to another topic. Let's go to Cleveland. Let's go to Progressive Field, where the pretty much the manager spot is looking to take fold as Terry Francona, the former manager for the Boston Red Sox, and Sandy Alomar Jr., a minor league manager for the Dodgers. Those are the two top candidates to become the manager of the Cleveland Indians. Alomar prepared for his first game as interim manager Friday, a day after Manny Acta was fired. GM Chris Antonetti said both are candidates and others currently employed by teams could become a part of the search. Francona said, quote, to the Associated Press, I'm excited and I'm honored that they would give me an interview. I know Sandy Alomar is also a candidate. He's a good friend of mine. I don't want to get too far ahead of myself. I will do my homework over the next week. So, Robert, between these two guys, if it comes up to these two guys, you have the interim manager right now for the Indians in Sandy Alomar, and then you got the former former Red Sox manager Terry Francona, who won two World Series. Who would you want?
Because Terry Francona.
That is the reason why.
That is no doubt, because Terry Francona is one of the best for the Red Sox, and you know it was kind of sad him leaving Boston, and you see why, because of what Bobby Valentine has done, and not very well at his job, and you know not a lot of players are thrilled with him. Everyone likes Terry Francona, and you see why Terry Francona brings a little bit more. You know, he's just more of a. He's just like a better guy in the clubhouse, I'd have to say. And he's always a fun guy to be around. I think he'll be a good candidate. I think he should be in the Indians Cleveland manager, Steven. And with that point, he will probably be in it. You know, this is also, Alomar said, you have to serve first. Be unselfish and do what you can for others. And that's what he does in his lessons. It is a lesson learned as a youngster from his father, Sandy. A major league infielder in the 1960s and 70s, Alomar's young brother Roberto was with his teammate in Cleveland, elected to the Baseball Hall of Fame in 2011. So, I mean, Terry Francona is probably going to have to be my candidate for that spot. What do you think, Steven? Who would you pick?
In this situation, I would go with... I would have to go with Terry Francona too. I have to agree with you, mainly because of the World Series rings and how much success that he's had on his resume. Taking over in 2004, and winning them a World Series pretty quickly. So that obviously made Red Sox fans very happy and really, really, really liking Terry Francona, but. Terry Francona did not get fired. He resigned from his job because of what happened in the clubhouse two seasons ago with the beer and the laziness of the pitchers and that type of stuff. He resigned himself. That was his own fault. He didn't get fired because of any wrongdoing. He barely missed the playoffs. And if he didn't resign himself and that never happened, the Red Sox would have made the playoffs possibly. And they could have made a run. So I think Terry Francona is the guy to get. He wasn't fired. And I think he's going to make a big difference for he'll make a big difference as the manager coming into spring training.
Now you see how Bobby Valentine has done. He's blowing the Red Sox organization from top to bottom.
Please fire him. He is... I know he has a good resume. He led the Mets to the World Series in 2000. They will eventually lose to the Yankees in that Subway Series. But, come on. He has put the Red Sox organization under the bus. He has the executives in the Red Sox organization can't do anything about it. Theo Epstein, he left during the offseason. Terry Francona, he left during the offseason. It was bad, and it's unfortunate to hear that and to see that the Red Sox are just fading and becoming the last place team now. And the Orioles being, actually, I'm happy for the Orioles for being that good team this year, that wild card team. So there's some good things about the AL East this year, with the Orioles doing so good this year. And then obviously the bad things, and that's obviously the Red Sox really making really disappointing the fans and really making a bad representation on the organization.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to agree with you on that, Ron Stevens. So let's move on to another topic here, as Braves honor Chipper Jones. Former Atlanta manager Bobby Cox and Hall of Famer Hank Aaron participated as the Braves paid tribute to Chipper Jones before Friday night's game against the Mets. Aaron gave Jones a third base with the words Chipper Jones 1993 to 2012. The special bases with the tribute to Jones were used in the game. The on-deck circles also carried the logo, and Jones' number 10 was painted in the grass in center field. Baseball commissioner Bud Selig said in a video message that Jones is a future Hall of Famer. It's obvious where we're headed, Selig said. The next time we also see you in Cooperstown, New York. Jones was 0-for-4 as the Mets beat the Braves 3-1. There was no video tributes to Jones between innings throughout. There were video tributes to Jones between innings throughout the night. I think I had a tear playing in the corner of my eye pretty much the whole night, Jones said.
He's a tough guy, Robert. He's tough. He has done so good for this organization. Chipper Jones is probably the classiest, most hardworking baseball player in Braves history. Forget Hank Aaron. He's done so much for the organization, but Chipper Jones has really given the Braves has risen the bar for class and high expectation for such a prestigious ball club. He's just done so much for this team. He's led them. He was a part of the Braves run in which they went to, like, I think it was like 12 straight playoffs or something like that. It was a very big streak. And he's retiring. And I wish I would never see this day come, but obviously it has to come always. And playing against the New York Mets, who he has done so good against in his career, especially a team in his division. He's done so great. I remember playing as him in backyard baseball, like in the first series in 2000, just long ago. So, Robert, it's going to be a sad ending to this, but I think that the Braves fans would probably have a loud, long standing ovation for him if the Braves win the World Series or if they get eliminated.
Yeah, you know, Chipper Jones has put a lot in the organization. In 19 years, he has played under two managers and two general managers.
Yeah, Bobby Cox and Freddie Gonzalez both have done just terrific jobs. Bobby Cox doing exceptionally well. Like I told you guys, leading the way for appearances, including one World Series title, I think, in 1996 or something like that, the year before the Yankees won 3 in a row. So, and then Frank Gonzalez leading the Braves to the playoffs last season. Actually, I don't think they were in the playoffs last season. No, they weren't. But, Frank Gonzalez, he's leading the team to the playoffs this year, so Chipper Jones couldn't ask for a better career, really. I have to say, That's all I have to really say anything. So
I remember going on the Giants.